Tesla seems to be dominating the news in the past couple of years. It's been built up as the savior of our outdated car industry. Granted, some of the news has been troubling, especially when the lens turns on the company's CEO, Elon Musk.
Tesla CEO Elon Musk is the subject of a new controversy.
He called a diver of the Thai cave rescue a pedo.
Smoking what podcast host Joe Rogan said was a marijuana and tobacco joint.
Despite all this, the electric car company has succeeded in placing battery-operated vehicles on the map, not just as an alternative to a conventional car, but as a serious competitor. Today, I'm going to wade through this green revolution hype by looking at the life cycle of Tesla cars in order to understand whether they are a clean and emissions-free solution to personal transportation. Let's start at the beginning, manufacturing. All cars require extraction of raw materials for processing and manufacturing. As a result, every conventional and electric car generates an environmental impact before they even hit the road. According to a two-year study conducted by the Union of Concerned Scientists on the life cycle of electric vehicles, however, this impact is usually 68% more emissions-heavy for long-range electric cars like Tesla's. In part, this is due to the energy-intensive process of extracting rare metals, which make up Tesla's lithium-ion battery and can be found throughout the car in headlights and onboard electronics. And the actual search and extraction process for rare materials can be extremely dirty. Lizzie Wade of Wired magazine points towards the Jiangxi mine in China, which digs massive 8-foot holes into the ground and then douses them with toxic chemicals in order to obtain a minuscule amount of rare earth. All told, Wade says 0.2% of what gets pulled out of the ground is used, and the other contaminated 99.8% is dumped back into the environment. Mining companies employ energy-intensive coal-fired or gas-powered equipment in order to successfully extract materials, resulting in high levels of greenhouse gas emissions. So, when we look at the manufacturing stage of Tesla's cars, then, it's not something that starts in the often touted Gigafactory. Instead, the metals used to create Tesla's sleek design have roots in a dirty extraction process halfway across the world. So in general, the manufacturing process of a Tesla car is much dirtier emissions-wise than a conventional car. But that changes quickly once the car starts moving. In the same 2015 study of electric cars, the Union of Concerned Scientists found that battery-powered cars make up for manufacturing's steep environmental cost after only 18 months of driving. However, this differs widely according to where you live, because electric cars still have emissions associated with them. It's just not coming out of their tailpipes. The environmental impact of a Tesla depends upon the type of grid you're plugging into. If it's reliant on dirtier energy sources, the car most likely will have lower miles per gallon equivalency, like in Colorado, where the equivalent fuel efficiency is around 35 miles per gallon. But in California, where there are much more renewables, using a Tesla might equate to something more like 87 miles per gallon. Overall, though, by the end of their time on the road, gas-powered cars have almost double the amount of emissions when compared to an electric vehicle like Tesla. Although, that all depends on where electric cars are plugging into the grid. Finally, on the waste end of its operations, Tesla does well in reusing spent materials. The CTO of Tesla, J.B. Straubel, told shareholders that they recycle and will recycle all of their spent cells, modules, and battery packs. But information about their recycling process is hard to come by. According to both NPR and Tesla's website, they recycle about 10% of the battery in-house and use a third party to recycle another 60% of the battery. All told, right now they recycle 70% of the battery. This is another important means of reducing waste and the company's impact, in that it not only diverts unnecessary waste from landfills, but it also reduces the environmental costs of manufacturing by using raw materials already in existence. Tesla's cars are, for the most part, more energy efficient and better for the environment than traditional gas-powered cars. and Tesla challenged a stagnant auto industry by pushing battery-powered cars into the mainstream as a viable alternative to conventional cars. But even so, their approach is environmentally limited. Buying a new car is certainly more wasteful than using what you've got. And buying electric vehicles and supporting a large corporation is not the solution to climate change, even though an electric car might lower your individual carbon footprint. So, should you go out and buy a Tesla right now to save the planet? Probably not. To me, it's better to invest time and money in groups organizing for climate action and legislation like the Sunrise Movement, or help local groups in your area work towards environmental justice. Electric cars do have a role to play in the climate movement, but they must be paired with so many other actions in order to create viable, lasting environmental change. Thanks so much for watching. If you are interested in supporting this channel, here are three things you can do. First, you can press the subscribe button and click the little bell next to it to get notified whenever I release a new video. Second, share this video around on Reddit and social media. And third, support this channel financially on Patreon. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you in 2 weeks.